How do you start an introduction to an amazing evening like this? Well, my dad always told me to start with a great rock and roll song quote. That brought to mind Imagine by John Lennon, and it goes like this. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one. And by the number of people here in attendance, I see that I'm not the only one. I see the people who are looking for tolerance, people who are looking for acceptance, and people who are looking for peace. Today is only a beginning, a first step. In our family, we have a saying. We say that it doesn't matter what you do, it matters that you do. It's a mindset. If you were exposed to a charity or advocacy organization here tonight, we hope that you get passionate about that group. We hope, and that if that happens, this event is a success. And we do hope that you get passionate about a cause. You should make a difference, and don't accept intolerance in others. But events like this don't just happen by themselves. I have to take a second and say thank you to the various people and organizations that made tonight a reality. I'd like to thank all of you for being in attendance here today, because without you, we wouldn't have been able to do this. It also makes me happy to know that so many people are accepted in all of this, or are interested in all of this acceptance and tolerance. I have to thank all of our various sponsors for helping us get either food or helping us provide all the services that were here today. I would also like to thank all of the participating charity groups and advocacy organizations, and I'd also like to thank all of the volunteers that were here. Finally, a big shout out to various individuals and groups who went above and beyond to help and make this event a reality. The Silverman family, all the employees at All Points Connect, the Steinberg family, people with the soul and rec, and also all of the many volunteers. Can we please take a second to give them all a round of applause? Alright, now you're all in for a real treat. I spoke last week at a program at Perry High School, and I saw a group called the Singing Fingers Choir. They're a part of the Deepwood Center Community Employment Service. Many of the members are hearing impaired, and their songs are presented using sign language and conventional gestures paired with traditional tunes. They are great examples of people overcoming differences and excelling. Please help me welcome Kim, Jenny, Denise, and Wendy, the Singing Fingers. Yeah.
Song to you.
Wow, you guys, great job. Let's give them another round of applause. Now, I have the honor and the privilege of introducing the mayor of Solon, Mayor Susan Drucker. And I remember our first meeting like it was just yesterday. We explained what happened that inspired us to make this event, and we proposed the idea of this tolerance fair, and there was no hesitance in her, on her part. She thought it was a great idea and asked, how can we help? That's the kind of person the Mayor Drucker is. She's kind, caring, she gets involved, she's approachable, and she's very committed. I am proud to say that she's become a friend of ours, and when you get a chance to see her, say thank you for all that she does for the city of Solon and that she does for you. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mayor of Solon, Susan Drucker.
Thank you, Justin, for that great introduction, and thank you, everyone. Good evening to all. Today is a proud day for the city of Solon. This phenomenal concept about a tolerance fair was inspired by our very own Justin Bachman, and I think we owe him a great round of applause. It did seem just like yesterday when Justin came into my office, but it was actually October 21st, 2010, when he came into my office with his parents, Ron and Lisa, and he wanted to pitch this idea about a tolerance fair. They wanted to take a negative situation that occurred in Justin's life and turn it into a positive that would impact others and help others in the future. His goal was to educate people on the acceptance of and tolerance of others who are different. So the question was, would the community embrace this kind of an idea? And I have to tell you, the turnout here tonight is overwhelming. And Justin, I think the turnout shows you this exceeded probably your expectations as well. And you should be extremely proud of yourself for all that you've done. Not only that, has Justin made an impact on our community here in Solon and the surrounding communities, but the word of his idea of a tolerance fair has already reached as far as Washington, D.C. So thank you, Justin, for being an example to all of us. And thank you to all of you. Your participation and presence here tonight has proven this to be a great success, and this is only the beginning for the city of Solon being the city of tolerance, thanks to Justin Bachman. Justin, I'm going to ask you to come on up here with me. I have two things I'd like to present to Justin today. The first, when I said this reached all the way to Washington, D.C., I received a certificate of congressional recognition and achievement presented to Justin Bachman in recognition of his introducing the idea of a tolerance fair and inspiring the community to have an open mind on behalf of Congressman Stephen LaTourette. And then, Justin, I also would like to present you a proclamation on behalf of the city of Solon, and I'd like to read that for everyone tonight. This is from the Office of the Mayor, a proclamation, whereas the city of Solon is pleased to extend special congratulations and recognition to Justin Parker Bachman for his efforts to make us a city of tolerance. And whereas Justin Parker Bachman brought forth the idea of the city of tolerance and the tolerance fair on October 21st, 2010, and furthermore has since worked diligently towards educating the community on accepting people with differences. And whereas Justin Parker Bachman is the beloved son of Ron and Lisa and brother of Stephanie and Connor, and through their help, love, and support has started his life's mission of bringing awareness to society. And whereas Justin Parker Bachman is an eighth grader at Solon Middle School, and his many hobbies include running cross country for his school team, in addition to playing alto saxophone, shooting pool, and cooking. And whereas Justin Parker Bachman is a source of courage and strength to all of us that have had the opportunity of knowing him. And now, therefore, I, Susan A. Drucker, Mayor of the City of Solon, on behalf of our City Council and our residents, do hereby recognize and congratulate Justin Parker Bachman and commend and celebrate this outstanding young man as a source of inspiration and pride to our community. Thank you, Justin, for all you do.
Thank you so much, Mary Drucker. Alright. I don't know what I'm about to say right now, and I don't know if there's anything enough that I can say. I'm about to do one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. I have to think of words to describe my mom. I know, you might not think it's that hard or that difficult, but my mom is beyond words. If I had to think of some words that only come close to describing her, those words would be amazing, caring, outgoing, and hardworking. Mom has helped me through so many things, and it's hard to believe. But this one really takes the cake. If you knew how much time and effort my mom put into this fair, you would be amazed. She went from being just normal Mrs. Bachman to the powerhouse that started this. She was making calls all the time to get charities and advocacy groups here, and look how that turned out. Our original hope was to have 15 organizations. My mom, the powerhouse, made that number almost triple. Mom, I love you, and I always will. So, Mom, please stand up. Please, everyone realize this could not have happened without you. Wait a second, what about his dad? And I often think that too. But I do have to thank one of the most important people in my life. Dad, now I know I could go on and on about how if it wasn't for you pushing me to do what I need to, that it wouldn't happen tonight, but that isn't fun. That would also take way too long. Instead, I'm gonna say, Dad, you're the best. I don't think I'd be able to keep my sanity without being able to be insane around you. I love joking around with you, and it's the highlight of many of my days. So, Dad, I hope to keep you around a lot longer. And apparently Mom feels the same way, because in exactly 1 month, Mom, Dad, congratulations on 25 years together. The main thank yous tonight, but there is one man that I haven't mentioned, and this is a very important person to me. His name's Mark. Mark has been there to recognize some of my greatest successes, but has also been there to guide me through some of my darkest times. And Mark is also one of the most inspiring people I know. And now I have to read the introduction that they told me to read. Mark knows the importance of understanding people's differences. He was born with a rare disease that left him with virtually no intestines, and at the age of 9, he developed a neurological disorder called Tourette syndrome. Now, at the age of 25, he is inspiring audiences all across the country by sharing his life story to convey the value of tolerance and the basic attitudes and behaviors that allow it to flourish. Now, that's what I was supposed to read you. This is what I'm going to actually say. Mark is going to inspire all of you. He changed my life. I hope he's going to change yours. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 2011 Speaker of the Year, Mr. Mark Elliott.
If you have seen me speak before, I cry.